They're very unique business that's only open Thursdays, Fridays, Saturdays, with the exceptions to Sunday to Wednesdays. I'll take it over to Jared.
So just a little history about the wine called Bistro. It started as a family business at the farmer's market with Chris and Mary Blunt's kids, Eric and Katie. And they sold pastas and like olive oils and stuff. And they eventually sold the business 10 years after they opened it. And Chris started to pursue his next family business. This started at the wine bank. He opened up a newsletter for them. And he featured 4 wines each week. And then he also held an event for them called Big Reds and Barbecue, which was basically wines that he liked paired with barbecue that was like on a prefix menu. And that after he had that business, it gave him the idea to start his own restaurant called the Wine Vault and Bistro.
So the Wine Vault and Bistro caters to those looking to enjoy a night on the town of San Diego. They're known throughout the community for their winemaker dinners, which they usually host about 35 to 40 throughout the year. Aside from their dinners, they offer weekly wine tastings, usually every Saturday. And if you're like worried about getting bored with the menus, if you're gonna go every Saturday, they just change it from week to week. Aside from the winemaker dinners and their tastings, they also offer wine vault tours. You can check the calendars if you want to see when the tours are, when the next upcoming one will be. And if you like the experience that your experience at the Wine Vault Bistro so much that you want to take it home with you, they also offer a wine shop on the first floor of the restaurant in which they sell their various wines to take them home, or if you want to order them in the restaurant as well, you can do so.
All right, so my name is Marilyn. I'll be talking about psychological analysis and as well as demographic analysis. So our establishment typically pertains to those who are familiar with wine. However, Wine Vault and Bistro devotes itself to accommodate for all. There are many different kinds of wines that can relate to different kinds of taste buds. Wine Vault and Bistro have been notoriously successful for generously devoting their establishment and menu to different crowds. It goes to show that the wine knowledge is not limited to those who are familiar with it, because Wine Vault and Bistro folks to spread the love and knowledge wine has to offer. As far as demographic analysis, being that Wine Vault Bistro is located in the coastal region of San Diego, it indeed exhibits the SoCal easygoing lifestyle. Wine Vault Bistro menu consists of various types of seafood, not only to connect to the culture of San Diego, but also connect those who want to learn about wine and how to relate it to different kinds of dishes. The demographic age group this establishment pertains to is 21 and older. By devoting to particular days of the week to a specific audience builds not only their reputation, but also their customer intake. Besides being a welcoming destination, San Diego is also known for having a beautiful wine country known as Temecula Valley, making it a convenient resource for Wine Vault and Bistro.
All right, so now I'm gonna talk about the individual and environmental influences. So individually, some people might be influenced by their moods to have a glass of wine or to have a fancy dinner, and this could be caused either if they got a pay raise at work or if it's someone's birthday. So the holidays are also big when it comes to consumer spending. So we like to take advantage of this and have specific menu items during the holidays. And people may also be influenced by the weather. So if it's sunny out, if it's cold, a lot of people have different moods pertaining to the weather. So like for example, holidays, it's a little cold, so we accommodate for that as well. And this is the decision-making process. So consumers become aware, involved, consider, purchase, then they consume, and then they are loyal, and then they advocate for the business. So this is what drives the Wine Vault and Bistro. It's what gets people coming back.
So for social, cultural, and ethical influences, because we rely heavily on word of mouth marketing, social reference groups are actually really important to us, as they are our biggest influencers when it comes to the decision-making process, specifically the primary groups. And our primary groups are our close friends, family, and other people that we interact with often. And they're important to us because of their sensory memory. They've already been to Wine Vault and Bistro, so they want to share that experience with you. So it's very important that we leave a positive taste in our consumers' mouth.